So with our four-step approach, we've got to understand what does each step do for us, okay? The first step is just our start step, okay? And it's a walk. That's really all we want to do. And what we're trying to do is we're trying to get to a starting point so that our last two steps can give us range into where we want to go get to the ball, okay? So really our first step is just walking into it. And where we start walking into that, we want to make sure that we have visual on where the ball is coming from, okay? And our second step, let's say we're running a second step tempo, meaning the ball is in the setter's hands, we're on our second step. That's all our second step is doing now. Notice my first two steps pretty much follow the same line, okay? Now from here, I've created what a loaded step, okay? From here, this what this means is I can push off and I can go straight, or I can push off going right. So my last two steps could be in a straight line. That's really important to know. My first step is a walk step. My second step walks into a load. And now from here, my third step is my drive, okay? This is going to get me to the ball with a certain amount of distance. All right, so as soon as I see the ball, I am going to sprint, drive that foot to the ball, right? And typically what I'm doing is I'm trying to get the ball inside my right foot. Okay, I'm trying to get the ball inside. And my arms go back, which we know. And now from here, this is the important part about this. When I step with my left foot plants in the same direction as my right foot. So that way when I lift and I rotate, I'm in a good position. Okay, lots of times what we see is different variations of this to where this foot will be straight, this foot will turn. Now you can look, the angles of my legs are not the same angle. That's problematic. I'm gonna catapult off my leg, right? And what's gonna happen is my right knee is gonna push against the outside of my left knee, okay? And then I'm gonna land on one foot, so my knee's gonna take a beating. So if any of you have some knee pain, some back pain, if you've had a stress fracture, this is probably what you've been doing, is that you've been driving, right, over that and then landing, so you're in a compromised position. The other thing that we're looking at, which we don't really wanna do, is we don't wanna pivot from our last step, okay? These last two steps are the driving steps. We don't want it to be a step pivot, because that step pivot is gonna do some of the same thing. It's not, notice on my pivot, it's not winding my hip up at all, okay? The pivot is just grounding me, and yes, it's helping me get up in vertical, but there's a better way of doing this, okay? If we want to adjust, if we wanna have a pivot step, let number two be our pivot step, because now I could go straight, right? Or I can pivot right, but if you notice, my feet are always gonna go in the same direction. By doing so, it's gonna promote healthy jumping. Look, all my joints are going and bending in the same direction. If they're bending in the same direction, I'm gonna pull energy from them up into the same direction. Now my whole body is working together to help me get to the ball.